Hello Shopify merchant, this is your host. Today I'll help you to set up our essential upsell app for your Shopify store. So let's get started. So first of all, let's create a funnel. You just need to click on create funnel, go to the funnel, you just need to add the funnel. Currently I'm just creating up a funnel for product page. I'll just set the autopilot mode here and product page upsell, and I just wanted to display on all product. Wanted to display three offers will be fine for all my products. And all I just need to do is to activate the app embed and app lock in order to work with our Shopify. So you just need to go to the customizer and enable the app lock. Yeah. Users need to enable the Essentialwolf app locks from here, and as you can see, you won't see any block here. So let's add block. Yeah, it's okay. So users need to add this app block so that it will work flawlessly with 2.0 threads. And once we have added the app block here below the buy now button, disable it. So as you can see, our product page upsell is set up perfectly. So let's check it out if it's working or not. Go to the catalog. As I created the app block or product page upsell for all products, so it will display here. Again, it's working fine. You can add the product. You can even increase the quantity whenever you want. So if you go to the cart page, you will even do see the quantity as well as the product that you added from our app. So let's modify the look and feel of the block. You just need to go to the analytics, go to the setting. As we are given the preset option, you can choose whatever the preset option you want. But currently I'm just making it the default. And here I can set up the exact background, what exactly I want, whatever. Apparently we can go with this flow. Even you can adjust here. If you want to display the list view or the slider view, you can adjust the settings and look and feel here. If you want to enable the quantity button, disable the quantity button, you can do it from here side, as well as the notifications. But apparently I'm just leaving the setting here as it is now, and just you can save it now. So now let's check if our settings get applied or not. Yes, our setting looks perfectly fine. As you can see, you can check the analytics. We have even the full page analytics, product page, whatever you can. And now you can even edit the funnels as per your requirement. Suppose you want to display the funnel on specific pages, specific products. So you just need to add the product funnel. We say I just want to display the funnel on these two. Not more than that. So I want to display these as a funnel. Even you can see the preview here and click on save button. Yeah. Let's check it out if it's working or not. It's totally working fine. I added three products in a funnel. It's totally working fine. If I go to this one, no, okay, as I added the funnel for both. So as you can see, this is how you can do it with the product pages. You can create the funnel for same, for card, post purchase, thank you, whatever you can say, you can do it. Thank you so much for having me.